I'm Annie Kroll, a producer at Viewpoints Radio. This week, I did a little bit of digging into one of my favorite literary and cinematic series of all time, Harry Potter. I wanted to know what kind of impact reading about and watching strong female characters like Hermione Granger may have on our culture. Turns out, I'm not the only one who was curious about one of J.K. Rowling's most beloved characters. I chatted with the creative media manager for MuggleNet, which is one of the largest online Harry Potter fan organizations in the country. As a millennial, Hogan had some thoughts about how her generation has taken Hermione's spirit out of the books or off the screen and into their everyday lives.
As a whole, looking at Hermione and the Harry Potter books as a foundation of modern feminism, I think, is a very interesting tool, because you look at it and, you know, who's really leading the feminist movement right now, right? It's millennials. They're kind of out there in front, leading the charge right now on a lot of big movements, because they're starting to come into that age group of being more powerful in society. And really, what millennial hasn't read Harry Potter, right? When you look at the numbers, over 500 million copies sold since 1997. That's huge.
Though not everyone will be waiting around for their acceptance letter from Hogwarts. In fact, a number of Americans refuse to let their children even read the books, let alone discuss them. Why? Because of the sorcery that flows through the entire series. One Nashville Catholic school this September actually banned the book after consulting exorcists because they believed the incantations in Harry Potter could conjure evil spirits if read aloud. Mimi Gladstein, an English and literature professor at the University of Texas in El Paso, has dealt with her fair share of banned books. Gladstein also authored an essay titled Feminism and Equal Opportunity, Hermione and the Women of Hogwarts. So she has studied the value of the series with a great deal of care. Obviously, I'm sure you know this as well as anyone, but there are parents and there are school boards who ban Harry Potter and don't allow it to be read by their children just because of the witchcraft element. How would you respond to a parent or to a school board administrator who doesn't want it in their schools?
Well, of course, you know, that other right. I was at one time president of the Steinbeck Society of America, and that was another problem that Steinbeck faced, too, is being, you know, censored, or people not wanting to teach his works because of things that were shown in there. Of course, you know, my idea is that you want to let people know about everything and then educate them to have integrity, and then let them make those choices.
Has Hermione made a difference in your life? If she hasn't, you might want to curl up with one of the 7 books this holiday season, or host a cozy watch party sometime soon. Check out the full story wherever you listen to podcasts and on viewpointsradio.org. Also follow Viewpoints Radio on Twitter and Instagram for more behind the scenes.